अस्सलाम वालेकुम व्यूअर्स, आज सुनते हैं शेखुल इस्लाम डॉक्टर मोहम्मद ताहिर कादरी साहब की जुबानी कुरानिक इंसाइक्लोपीडिया का खुलासा।
बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। कुरानिक इंसाइक्लोपीडिया इज वन ऑफ माय हंबल सर्विसेज टू द कुरान। इट्स अरबिक एंड उर्दू वर्जन has already been launched and now its Arabic and English version is being launched in first week of August. I have not compiled this Quranic encyclopedia to introduce Quran to the people. Rather, this work introduces certain Quranic sciences and Quranic subjects and different aspects of Quranic knowledge to us. Quran does not need an introduction. It is we who need the Quran. It is we who need to be introduced to ourselves. Quran is the book sent down for the mankind and it declares that it is light. Since Quran is light itself, so it does not need any external help, any external factor or any external support to become manifest and visible. It is clearly stated in Holy Quran that Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was raised to the mankind in order to bring them out from the darkness into light. It removes the darkness from human life, from our minds, from our hearts, from our character, from our behaviors, from our temperament, from our social interactions, from our desires. Quran removes the darkness and converts it into light. So if we need to come into light, it is the Quran that takes us to light. If we need knowledge and remove the ignorance, it is the Quran which takes us out from the ignorance and provides us with knowledge. If we need life, it is the Quran which takes us from the darkness of death into the light of life. Quran is the guidance, and the guidance which has no place for any kind of ignorance, no place of any kind of doubt, no place of any kind of confusion. This is the meaning of ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهُ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. We are in the darkness of ignorance. We don't know our own reality. We don't know the truth about the universe. We don't know the truth about our own existence. We don't know the truth about our own life. We need to know who we are. We need to know what we are. We need to know where we have come from. We need to know where do we stand in this world. We need to know where we are going to. We need to know what is our relationship with our Creator, with our Lord. We need to know what is our relationship with this universe. We need to know what is the nature of our and what should be the nature of our relationship with fellow human beings, with other people. What should be the nature of our relationship with Muslims, with non-Muslims? How should we behave with animals, with other creatures of the world? How should we behave with our friends and our enemies? How should we behave with our juniors and with our seniors? How should we behave with those whom we like and love? And how should we behave with those whom we don't like, whom we dislike and we hate? So Quran is the book and Quran is the source of light which has provided us with every kind of guidance, with every kind of knowledge, with every kind of consciousness, with wisdom and every kind of understanding. So that's why we need to learn the Holy Quran. We need to become the pupils of Holy Quran. And those who learn the Holy Quran and make a place in their heart for Holy Quran, and those who enlighten their hearts and their souls and their spirits with the light of Quran, and those who receive the blessings of the knowledge of Holy Quran, they get rid of the ignorance, they get rid of the darkness, because the pupils of Quran can never die, and every death for them becomes a new birth. And that birth takes them into the new realm, the new worlds of higher ranks. Since we are living in a world of this animal existence, we are living in an atmosphere of selfishness, atmosphere of materialistic pursuits. We are living in the world of the materialistic desires. That's why it has taken us down from our higher status in which the human beings were originally created by the hands of God. We need our self-purification. We need spiritual rehabilitation. And for this rehabilitation, and for this purification, and for this perfection, we need to gain the knowledge of the Quran, which has been revealed by Almighty Allah. And this Quranic encyclopedia, which I have compiled, is a humble service to the knowledge of Quran. I don't claim that every single science and every single subject has been discussed in this encyclopedia. No human being can claim such. I have tried to compile most of the Quranic subjects, possibly most of the Quranic sciences, in this compilation, in this collection. And any reader who wants to become a true student of Quran and wants to receive the guidance from Quran, this Quranic encyclopedia will definitely facilitate him in Quranic learning. This Quranic encyclopedia will definitely lead the student of Quran towards right path. This Quranic encyclopedia will certainly open the new horizons of human understanding, new horizons of understanding the Quranic knowledge. If anybody likes to get the knowledge of the matters of Islamic faith, so I have given them subject wise in a proper order. So just you open the chapter of the Islamic faith, and all Quranic verses which contain the subjects of faith, whether faith in the oneness of Almighty Allah, faith in the prophethood and the messengers, faith in the life hereafter, faith in the angels, faith in the day of resurrection, and all important matters of faith, wherever they are discussed in the Holy Quran, in different parts and different chapters, you will find by the grace of Almighty Allah at one place, in a systematic order. So it has become very easy for the teachers, for the students, for the lecturers, for the preachers and speakers, for the teachers and ulama and scholars, even for the beginners. And you see, I have collected all relevant Quranic commandments on family life, and in context of family life, the rights of husband, rights of wife, rights of children, rights of women, rights of relatives, rights of family. You will find every single heading and chapter, and you will find all relevant verses of the Holy Quran at one place, in a very systematic order, under different headings and subheadings. If you need to know about human rights, you will find it in under specific chapter. If you need to know our obligations, moral obligations to others, and by others, I mean towards the families, towards the neighbors, towards relatives, towards brothers, towards friends, towards enemies, towards Muslims, towards non-Muslims, even towards animals, towards birds, you will find every single aspect under a specific heading. If you need to know about the reality of the human creation, coming to the scientific subjects, you will find under the subject of human creation, its embryonic development, its chemical development and evolution. You will find how the life of a man, the life of a human starts in the womb of its mother. What are the developmental stages of an embryo? If we need to know about the creation of the universe, you will find a specific chapter. All relevant verses of Quran, you will find together and different captions. If you need to know about the space, if you need to know about the time, if you need to know about the stars, about the planets, about the sun, about the creation of earth, the shape of the earth, of the moon, and many other scientific things regarding astronomy, science of astronomy. So there are Quranic contents on cosmology, on creation of universe, expansion of universe, on the subject of the balance between different objects of the universe. Relating this subject relates to the gravitation and beginning of the universe till the end of the universe, including the details regarding different planets, black holes, and many other important aspects, cosmological aspects, which are discussed in the Holy Quran. There is a chapter or a full-fledged part on the state, and you can find maximum Quranic contents on the subject of state. Politics, rules of government, establishment of courts, establishment of justice, administration of justice, then human rights and human obligations. And in the same way, how to establish an Islamic state, how to establish the courts, what would be the rules to administer the justice, and how the law, rule of the law should be ensured, all these kind, how a good state based on democracy, based on human principles and human rights, and based on justice, socio-economic and political justice, how that state can be run. And then we find different subjects on biology, different discussions on botany, on vegetable world, on animal world, regarding the birds, regarding the plants. Then there are Quranic contents on mineralogy, different minerals. And then there are Quranic contents on different departments of human society and different departments of a state. For example, full-fledged chapter on economic laws, a chapter on laws related to finance and commerce, laws related to trade and business, laws related to agriculture and industry, laws related to human health, all commands regarding the acts of commission and acts of prohibition. Then there is a full-fledged chapter on good morals, good human behaviors, good human deeds, what is appreciable, what is commendable, and what is not. In the same way, there is another chapter on bad morals, bad deeds, bad behaviors, what is prohibited by Almighty God and what is not desirable. In the same way, we can see the modern subjects which are being discussed, which have become the necessity of human knowledge nowadays, in present time. For example, the subject of peace, toleration, tolerance, moderation, all Quranic contents in which we can find the condemnation of the different violent behaviors, extremism, terrorism, which has been condemned. Then there are contents on rebellion against the state, how it is condemned. It is not allowed. Then sanctity of human life and the protection of human rights, then rights of human beings, different aspects of human rights and obligations. In the same way, then we find in it the different manners of our society regarding the family life, regarding the religious life, regarding secular life, regarding the rights of neighbors, regarding rights of rulers, the rights of the ruled, rights of the people, rights of the poor, rights of the needy. Then human nature, there is a subject, there is a full-fledged chapter on human nature and human psychology. And there is a chapter on the discussion, Quranic contents on human mind, Quranic contents of heart, Quranic contents on soul, and different stages of soul, different kinds of soul. And Quranic contents of on the spirit, how to purify ourselves, how to advance our spiritual state. So regarding the spiritual aspect of human life, there is a full-fledged chapter. Regarding the material aspect, regarding the financial aspect, regarding the matrimonial aspect, regarding the business aspect, regarding the political aspect, regarding the economic aspect, regarding the national and local issues, regarding international issues, relation between communities. Then there are laws of war, laws of peace, laws of reconciliation, laws of treaties, how the communities should live together in peace, how the states should live together in peace, how the international relations should be discussed, what would be the rights of the Muslims in non-Muslim states, and what would be the rights of non-Muslims in Muslim states, and our relationship with the non-Muslims, with protection of their rights, protection of their life, protection of their property, protection of their wealth, protection of their business. In the same way, full-fledged chapter exists in this encyclopedia on the subject of knowledge, subject of science, and significance of knowledge, and different stages of knowledge, different kinds of knowledge, different sources of knowledge. All these things have been discussed. If we need to know anything about the battles which took place during the prophetic time, I mean the Battle of Badr, the Battle of Uhud, the Battle of Trench, or the conquest of Makkah, whatever we need to know, whatever is mentioned in the Holy Quran, we will find in under a single chapter. All details, all verses which were revealed in the context of this particular battle, in the context of that particular battle, in the context of that particular event which took place in the prophetic time, all the seerah matters, we will find under different chapters. And it is, I have not given different articles. There is no human research or human opinions in this encyclopedia. This is an encyclopedia based on an exclusive input of the Quranic knowledge. It is a unique, humble effort that all relevant aspects, religious and secular and scientific, and related to human life, related to the universe, related to the animal world, related to our bones, our different organs of our body, related to languages, related to history, related to culture, different nations, raising of different prophets, their communities, any subject which has been discussed in Holy Quran. I have tried to pick it up and put all relevant verses together in the form of a chapter under some heading to make the study and understanding of Quran under different sciences easy for the reader. So I have tried as much as I could to collect all relevant verses at single place on one subject. And the important thing which would be helpful for the reader, that is that I have established the, I have formed the headings, and every single heading is in fact a crux. The whole theme which has been discussed in a particular verse or in a set of particular verses or in some paragraphs, paras of the Holy Quran, I have given the heading which reflects the whole theme, the whole main context and crux of the whole teaching which are being discussed in the following verses. So these headings are in fact keys to understand the different sciences and different subjects of the encyclopedia. I think this Quranic encyclopedia should be present in every single house of a Muslim who wants to read Quran, any Muslim youth particularly who wants to understand Quran, who wants a direct guidance from Quran, a direct guide. What does Quran say on this particular subject? What does Quran say on this particular aspect? How does Quran guide me on this particular issue where I am confused? If anybody needs a direct guidance of Quran and direct light of Quran, this Quranic encyclopedia would be useful for that learner and for that searcher. I hope Almighty Allah may make this Quranic encyclopedia beneficial for the whole mankind and particularly for the Muslim youth. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.